2K Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA. The 2K Sports pregame show.
In a few moments, we'll be sending you out to Philadelphia as the 76ers go up against the Toronto Raptors. For Toronto, sixth place in the conference where they stand at the moment may not sound out of this world, but this is a team that no one in the East wants to face come playoff time. Let's talk about Marc Gasol, former Defensive Player of the Year, a guy who really understands how to work to his strengths. Kenny?
Yeah, I do. I do.
I'm not keeping you up over
no,
there.
No, you know,
hey,
I'm just thinking.
What about Marc Gasol?
No, I was just thinking as a Defensive Player of the Year, this guy has such awareness, positioning, and he understands how to use his size. He may not turn out the way we traditionally see the Shaquille O'Neals of the world, but he's an admirable force.
Yeah, he grew up in that Memphis style of play, grit and grind, hard nose, very little glam to his game.
I'm trying to figure out what he was saying.
I have no idea.
You know what he was saying?
He's over there sleeping.
Oh, excuse me? What did he say?
Wake up.
Sorry.
See? There you go again.
Wake up.
And the 2K Sports crew got it covered.
And a glimpse inside the locker room. Players' final few moments to prepare for the game and the task ahead. Certainly one of the most beautiful structures in the most historic city in the U.S. That's City Hall here in Philadelphia. Hello, basketball fans. You've got it on 2K Sports as we get set to bring you an exciting NBA basketball game. With Greg Anthony and Chris Webber, this is Kevin Harlan. David Aldridge will be reporting from the sidelines. D.A., it's all yours.
Well, the process in Philly has finally started yielding big results. The Sixers have star players and tremendous fans who stood by them through the lean years, and they're ecstatic at what they're seeing on the court. There are a handful of elite teams in the East, Kevin, but the Sixers are confident they belong with the best of them.
They certainly can. Well done, D.A., thank you. And making our way toward the finish line, this is a great time to check out the new power rankings. You take a look at the 76ers. They're stuck in the same spot, still outside the top three.
And you know, for the Raptors, they've experimented with a lot of options this season, but at some point, you are what you are. And that's a pretty good basketball team moving forward.
Here are the five for the Raptors. Lowry and Powell, the guards. Anunoby and Siakam in at the forward slots. And it's Gasol in at the center. And for the 76ers, the tall lineup out there for the 76ers. Simmons, Richardson, Harris, Horford, and Embiid. And coming into this season, questions about whether the Sixers could retain their star players. Well, Greg, they shuffled the decks, but they still have great talent.
Swapping in Al Horford for Jimmy Butler, Josh Richardson for J.J. Redick. The Sixers still in the mix to come out of the East.
Harris, good.
What a beautiful shot by Tobias Harris. I mean, he's getting very consistent from there. Now, it's just a matter of getting better and better.
Now here's Powell, and it's blocked. Now Simmons. Over Lowry. No good from Simmons. And so Siakam will bring it up for Toronto. It's a three-point game. Last time they met was in Toronto.
And their last time playing this club, foul trouble became a big problem for them. Their starters had to take an early stint on the bench.
Yeah, and they can't afford a repeat of that. They need a lot more minutes out of their core group tonight.
So it's Toronto now after Ben Simmons miss. And there's the call on Tobias Harris. That's his first foul. And just about a minute into the first quarter. Simmons against Lowry. A wide open look for Gasol.
0 for 3, not the start they're looking for.
And again, no good by Toronto. Richardson kicks to Simmons. Floats one, and he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And Toronto called for the foul.
What about the speed and the muscle Simmons has? I mean, it makes defenders nervous, if you ask me. Such a difficult matchup.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First free throw is good.
And when he gets ahead of steam, you almost feel sorry for defenders. Ben Simmons, a combination of size, speed, and ball handling that can at times be unstoppable.
And Simmons drops them both. And with his passing and driving ability, Greg, Simmons is like combining a power running back in football with a pinpoint passing quarterback. Not much he can't do.
Kevin, a football metaphor is appropriate. Simmons grew up playing Australian rules football, and the physicality and quick thinking of that sport really reflected in his style of play.
And Embiid with the block.
Awesome timing on the rejection. Embiid, the big fella. You don't want to bring it in around this guy. They've missed three of their first four shots, having a little trouble finding their legs.
Powell against Richardson. Now here's Powell. He gives his team some nice contributions, averaging a bit over 10 points a game. Just five on the clock. Alley-oop try, and it's blocked by Simmons.
By the reach of Simmons, I mean, coming into play on these blocks, you got to be careful shooting around this guy.
If you're just tuning in, we've played about 2.5 minutes here in the first. To the paint, he's looking for Horford and finds him. And he lays it straight in.
Well, there's just no slowing down Horford or any big man for that point when he gets in that deep. The defense is there, but he's just a master at taking the strong inside.
Now, here's Siakam. Turned in an outstanding game against Golden State. Inside, Harris. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. Well, we knew that Tobias Harris would be one of the big names during free agency this past summer.
Wasn't a lot of speculation for him when free agency hit. Ends up staying with the Sixers. And I think it makes sense for both sides, and he fits nicely next to Embiid.
Shooting two.
That's good from Harris. Chris, you look at the grind of a regular season. Adam Silver seems open to fewer games or even fewer minutes per game. What do you think of that?
This is one that I'm not with, Kevin. You know, in my day, you had guys play 82 games. And let's go back to the days of Bill Russell and Wilt Chamberlain. They were playing in shoes that basically were socks, and they didn't have tape, and they didn't have all the things that we're privy to in the medical industry. So I think we should keep it at 82 games and minutes the same, because it keeps a full context of sports where you can talk about Harden versus or Westbrook versus a Big O. It keeps the argument in the same place. I think fewer games, fewer minutes starts to change the dynamics and the expectations of what players can do. I don't mind changing it, adding tournaments, letting guys get more rest, but I think the number of games and the minutes of the game has to stay 48 minutes, has to stay 82 games in my opinion.
Very interesting. No good on that one. Raptors trail by six. And it's blocked. And it's out of bounds. The Raptors able to retain possession here. And stolen by Horford. And here we go. Richardson heading to the hoop. So it's Richardson with the jam.
Veteran instincts there. Horford does a great job of sniffing out when they go after steal.
And it's Lowry with the ball. Brings it up for the Toronto Raptors. Trailing here by eight. Passes to Powell. Top of the key, Siakam. And the rejection by Embiid. Here's Simmons, and Simmons slams it in.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Going for the juggler right off the bat. I mean, jumping out to an impressive early lead.
Lowry passes to Siakam. And Siakam throws it down.
Oh, great flow to that possession. Two players totally in sync with each other.
Richardson kicks to Simmons. Baseline jumper. Rebound by the Raptors.
He's not using his head this quarter. He's got to get back to finding high percentage shots.
To the wing right side. Here's Lowry. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. That's on Ben Simmons.
A five-time All-Star. Lowry has come a long way since being drafted 24th overall back in 2006.
First free throw is good. And some changes here for the Raptors. Serge Ibaka, he's checked in for Gasol. Hollis Jefferson comes in for OG Anunoby. And it's Fred VanVleet in for Norman Powell. And so Lowry nails both of them.
Probably as close to a sure thing as you can have at the free throw line.
Here's the pass to Richardson. Pass to Horford. That's his second shot and his second basket. He's 2 for 2.
And the powerful frame of Horford, I mean, enabling him to rumble through the defensive resistance to put it home.
Siakam with it. They count on his contributions, currently providing 16.5 points a game. 6 on the shot clock. Trying to get open is Ibaka. Horford with the rebound.
It's a very aggressive defense to prevent the easy lay-in.
It's Richardson on the wing. Now recovering. Pass to Embiid. Philadelphia moving the ball around. Simmons on the wing. He had 10 points in the win against Washington.
Yeah, but it wasn't all about himself. I mean, he kept everybody else in the loop. His passing was tremendous.
And this summer, a 5-year, $170 million max contract extension for Ben Simmons. The Sixers didn't want to give him any cause to look elsewhere. A great talent, but the hope with that kind
Take
of money
break.
Is
break.
That he'll develop
Two
that
shots.
Jump shot.
And the first one drops. A lot of player rejections in the playoffs last year. In fact, the highest in 3 decades. Seems like tensions, Chris, with the officials are still escalating.
Well, yeah, the relationship between the players and the referees, it's always an ongoing process, and it's definitely getting better. But last year we had the highest number of new referees in the history of the NBA. And so you're going to have a growing pains when you have younger guys and understanding the culture of the league. But I like the way that we're going, and some of those rejections were warranted. Some of them weren't. I just look at that year as, that just happened. Let's see what happens. I'm not going to hold players and referees accountable to last season. I think we need a little bit more context before we make a decision on player ejections and flagrants and things like that. Just a little more research. Look, when the D will give it to you, that's where you want your shots coming from, arm's length from the bucket.
Burke looking over the floor. Over Lowry. Burke can't get it to go. Raptors trail by 7. Here's VanVleet. That one a tad offline to the right, but drops in for him. VanVleet's got his second bucket of the game to go. Here's Burke. No points in the game yet for him. Passes it to Scott. Outside, Simmons. The 76ers need to get off a shot, and it's blocked by Ibaka.
And while he's been the NBA's leader in blocks multiple times, Ibaka just has that rare instinct for it. It puts the D in a tough spot when you have a point guard who can throw it down.
He really does, G.A. He really does put pressure on you.
And guys, it's clear, though, he enjoys showing off his athleticism. The D can't give him these opportunities.
Now, here's Burke. Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game. Simmons inside the one. The 76ers again can't hit it.
Well, he has to work harder to get a good high percentage look. I mean, he's been taking some bad shots out.
And there's the call on Joel Embiid. That is his first foul of the game. 76ers. Lowry finds Van Vliet. Here's Boucher. Back to Van Vliet. With the floater. Shots good by Ibaka.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
Burke, the pass to Thibault. There's a minute 34 left in the first. And it's plucked by Ibaka. Here's Lowry, and the Raptors tack on two more.
And with the body control and jump shot Lowry possesses, he has been known to torch you from the perimeter.
And the 76ers decide to take their first timeout here.
Yeah, things not going their way, and he wants to just try to talk this one over.
Well, the defensive intensity has to pick up, and I'm sure Coach is going to let them know that.
And let's check out a breakdown. Looking at some stats for Embiid.
And he's fallen out of favor a little bit in their offense, at least compared to how he was being used earlier in the season. His usage percentage is down over the past five games. Maybe he'll be more involved here tonight.
Now, here's Scott. He's been patient so far, nothing on the scoreboard yet, and out of bounds as Toronto gains possession. Raptors with the lead. Guys, this offense very effective.
And guys, the defense has been no match. They've just picked them apart.
The pass to Boucher. A floater. Dishes it to Ibaka. Pass to Van Vliet. Clock at six. Hangs in the air. Good on the shot. Now it's a three-point Raptor lead.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
Feibel, the pass to Burke. 29 seconds left to play in the first quarter. There's the steal. Here's Van Vliet. That one is good. He's only missed one shot of his six taken on the floor.
Just like butter. The finger roll is all about the feel. He's got plenty of that.
And here is Burke. Out left to the wing. Here's Feibel. And the last second attempt does not go in for him. And so the first quarter is in the books. The Raptors out in front. They lead by five. And back in a moment as we'll get underway with quarter number two. And Serge Ibaka talked about his skill set and how it complements Kyle Lowry and Pascal Siakam and what he brings to the team.
Playing my defense toughness, my experience, playing with those two guys, one of the best in the game right now, and then, you know, helping those two here, and with my experience, what I learned, I think I can help the team a lot, energy, and both hands on the floor.
And really, Ibaka is a seasoned veteran now, a terrific role player known for his defense.
And Ibaka knows his role and plays it well.
And for those of you just tuning in, the second quarter of action is where we're at right now. And from what we've seen so far from the Raptors, guys, your thoughts?
Yeah, in that first period, they looked to push in transition at every opportunity.
With the game being fast-paced these days, you can expect this from a lot of teams, but they did it very well.
Kyle O'Quinn out there with Mike Scott. Then it's Ennis, then there's Burke, and it's Feibel in at the shooting guard position. That's the group in the game for the 76ers. Now Burke, nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Shot clock at six. Jacks up a three. It's hauled in by the Raptors. Boucher's got five rebounds tonight. Pass to Van Vliet. Down low. And it's blocked by O'Quinn. Here's Feibel. Hits some rim on the way in, and the bucket's good. Quarter number two with just over a minute gone. Powell, the pass to Hollis Jefferson. Back to Powell. Shoots over Burke, and the Raptors miss again.
With the D playing soft off him, he might have been better off taking it to the hoop instead of settling for the jumper.
The shot will not fall, and it's the Raptors taking it the other way. The Celtics will be coming into town for the next game, and that's the first game in a string of three straight at home. On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Kevin, Josh Richardson has made himself into one of the top defensive wings in the league. Richardson says there's a certain competitiveness that comes with being a good defender. The defensive end takes will, and I have a lot of it. Kevin J. Rich is self-described as super competitive, and that edge is what drives him.
It sure is. That's what it takes. Thank you, David. And only 6 feet tall in shoes, Fred VanVleet's not the biggest, but his toughness grew. His toughness, mentally and physically, is unquestioned.
And Kevin, growing up in Rockford, Illinois, gave him that perspective. Friends and family gone too soon. Basketball was the path to something better.
Here's Powell after the Sixers pick up two. VanVleet looking around and stolen by Burke. The 76ers trail by three. Pass to Ennis. Now here's Burke covered by VanVleet. Let's go. And that one's good. Burke's got his first 2 points. And so VanVleet will bring it up for the Raptors. They come in fresh off a win against the Warriors.
I felt like they attacked, but with a purpose. They knew what they wanted to accomplish coming in.
Aggressiveness is everything, and they certainly played with a ton of it to get that win.
Now here's Burke. High arcing shot. It's tipped. And they're running. Here's Powell. Finally gets one to fall. He's now 1 for 5 with his first make. The 76ers have gone 3 of 7 shooting the ball here in the second quarter. And Philadelphia calls time here. Players have different ways of leading. Some guys, Chris, are loud and fiery. Others let their play do all the talking. What was your approach?
Well, Kevin, it depended on what situation I was in. When I was in Sacramento, I could be the quiet, fiery guy that led through my actions because Vlade was more of a vocal guy, and we had a really good spirited team, so I didn't need to do much besides what we did in practice. In my younger days, when you want to win, you want to get out there, and maybe everyone doesn't have the sense of urgency that you do. You're a little bit more vocal, but I've always believed that the best leaders, no matter how well they communicate or anything else, the best leaders lead by example. And if you're telling everyone what to do and you're not doing it, usually it falls on deaf ears. So go out there and do it by example first, and everybody will follow.
Good advice. And the 76ers with a completely new group now. It's getting late in the season. Let's now see the standings out east. Taking a look at Philadelphia. What a run they've had this year in first place and charging seemingly at will toward the postseason. These guys have been outstanding. And, of course, Toronto down 5 spots from them.
And seeing where the 76ers are, they had a few critics coming into the season, and now I don't think they have any. This is a club ready to not only make a deep run, but possibly win it all.
You know, that's the mindset you have to have. They know if they can get to the playoffs, they have the talent to do some real damage.
There's VanVleet after the made shot from Joel Embiid. Anunoby passes to VanVleet. Richardson against Powell. Embiid with the steal. Harris dishes to Horford. Basket is good. The assist from Harris. Horford's got 6.
Now look, it's never easy to stop Horford. I mean, mainly because he's so strong and able to shrug off the deep.
That's tipped. VanVleet kicks to Gasol. Five to shoot. Here's Anunoby. Some solid defense from Harris. The 76ers leading. Simmons left side. Richardson outside. Knocks down the 3-ball. 5 points in the game.
Oh, great ball movement there.
Toronto, they've gone just 2 of 8 shooting here in the second quarter. Here's Siakam. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Yeah, way to play in attack mode and get to the line.
The Raptors shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game. free throw, no good. Kyle Lowry, he's checked in for Powell. He hits the second from the line. And it's the 76ers with the ball. They've only allowed 5 points in the quarter. They defeated the Wizards in their last game.
Yeah, I mean, we saw them do a little bit of everything in that game. Showed a lot of versatility.
Yeah, the offense looked cohesive last night. Whatever challenge the opposition presented, they answered with confidence.
Now here's Embiid. And Embiid throws it down.
I mean, stellar work on the offensive line. Embiid, I mean, his reach helps him track down many second-chance opportunities.
Van Vliet picks to Gasol. Good, and Van Vliet gets the assist. Van Vliet's got 3 assists tonight.
And when you've got a big man who can shoot from distance like that, what a huge advantage.
Simmons against Siakam. To the inside. Here's Horford, and finished off by Horford.
Great D. Simmons, the passing skills of a point. At 6'10", he can see the whole court.
So, timeout called here, the first for Toronto. You know what, Chris? Speed at any position is so vital. Who are the fastest big guys in the game right now that you admire and just can't believe how they go baseline to baseline?
No, but the first one that comes to mind is Giannis Antetokounmpo. I mean, he's a Greek freak, but he's a freak of nature in basketball.
He is.
His speed, his length, his athletic ability. You love seeing him. And I say a close second, Anthony Davis. And don't forget about Willie Cauley-Stein. I mean, a lot of guys that love running the floor and put that pressure on the defense every time by getting out.
Let's use this break in the action to show you the teams that in the last 10 games have been the NBA's best fast break teams. The 76ers number one, the Raptors third.
Both of these teams have established tempo as an identity. I mean, they're playing fast and scoring in bunches.
Gasol finds Lowry. The shot's good. Lowry's got 9.
Seeing the court like a point, that's Gasol showing the full range of his skills.
Richardson the pass to Horford. Back to Richardson. The pass to Horford. 6 to shoot. The 10-footer. Again, Philadelphia.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Now here's Van Vliet. Tight defense on him. It's blocked, and so the ball is out of bounds. Richardson touched it last. Gasol's in the post. Richardson cover. It's good. He's got 5.
Showing the muscle, Gasol skilled at powering through the contact and finishing.
And here's Simmons. He'll bring it up for Philadelphia. They've led by as much as 10. They'll be off to Charlotte for a game against the Hornets. That'll be just 1 game played away from home for them. Now, here's Richardson. He picked up 18 points in their last win against Washington. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And here's Harris from the arc. Another 3 for Philadelphia.
And just a great second quarter for them after such a difficult first, bringing that field goal percentage up from below 30 and now with the lead.
Here's Anunoby. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. A floater. And it's Joel Embiid with the rebound. Embiid's got 5 rebounds tonight. Simmons on the wing. Now recovering. Simmons passes to Horford. Here's Embiid, and good work on the boards. They pick up the second chance points. Now it's a 7-point Philadelphia lead. Toronto's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. Van Vliet passes to Lowry. 1:35 left now here in the second. Here's Van Vliet. That's in, coming off an assist from Lowry. Lowry's got three assists in the game. And Simmons kicks to Harris. 14 feet away, and the shot is long. Raptors trail by five. Rejected by Harris.
Oh, he's known for his offense more than defense. Harris plays with the high motor, and he likes to make plays.
It's Richardson on the wing, covered by Van Vliet. Here's Embiid. Looks good, is good. Bucket number four from the field. He's taken only six shots.
His individual effort has been outstanding tonight, and it's helped him grab the lead.
Lowry against Simmons. Rejected by Harris. Lowry against Simmons. Over Lowry. Embiid. And Embiid is right there. Embiid's got 10.
Some players might wear down during this kind of run. He's only getting strong.
1 second separating the shot clock and game clock. Now here is Lowry. 23 points for him the last game against Golden State. From deep three-point range, the shot misses.
And you could tell he thought he had a little more space, but the defender was right there.
Oh, man, did you see him close that gap? What a great job. He made the shooter feel uncomfortable.
And so it's the Philadelphia 76ers. Ahead by nine as the quarter comes to a close. They're playing a bruising game inside, and it's working for them. Back to the action after this word.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, basketball fans. What a pleasure it is to bring you into the 2K studios again. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. For the 76ers, the first quarter was pretty even. They never dug too deep a hole for themselves in the first period. The most they trailed by was five. In the second quarter, they turned on the afterburners, making a big charge to jump ahead and build a 9-point lead for themselves at halftime. Let's start with you, Shaq. What'd you think about the 76ers?
Well, Kenny knows about this. I used to do this to his team all the time. Take advantage of you down low. Mismatch. Barbecue chicken alert. Make good entry passes. That led to some good looks, obviously a lot of points. When you control the paint, Ernie, you control the game.
I was the master of controlling my paint. Shaquille O'Neal.
Looking at Toronto, Kenny, your thoughts.
Well, I think their problem is rebounding, Ernie. You know, when you're trying to come back in a game, every possession counts. Because each possession can turn into points, and you need to cut that deficit quickly.
And that'll do it for our halftime report. Stay tuned for the second half, about to get underway.
And we hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far. We're halfway through the game. Raptors trail by nine. And on the floor for Nick Nurse as we get into the second half. Anunoby and Siakam in at the forward slots. Aurean Powell, the guard. And it's Gasol in at the five down low.
And they're controlling the boards, Kevin. That's plus five in that category.
Simmons on the wing. While recovering, Simmons passes to Horford. Five on the clock. Simmons inside. Howl on him, and it goes down 2 points.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Siakam outside. and the rejection by Embiid. And it's out of bounds. The Raptors able to retain possession here. '76ers on defense. They lead by 11, the largest margin of the game.
Slow to get warm after the break. 0 for 3 now. Maybe they need an early timeout. It's just to try to settle things down.
He gets it in there. That's 7 points for Josh Richardson.
It's a great move, and he catches the defense completely off guard.
You'd like to see a little more energy coming out of halftime on the defensive end. He is a fantastic athlete for a power forward. Whatever he lacks in height, he makes up for with hops.
And Greg, Al Horford over the summer opting out of a contract with Boston, the final year with the Celtics. A bit of a surprise to fans.
You know, Horford said he wanted to test free agency. Talks between him and Boston abruptly ended, was wooed by several teams, but ultimately signed on with the Sixers.
Raptors trail by 13. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Here's Anunoby. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. And there's the call on Joel Embiid. And that'll be his third foul so far. And some changes here for the Raptors. Serge Ibaka has checked in for Gasol. Hollis Jefferson subbed in for OG Anunoby. And we're just about 2 minutes into the second half now. Lowry and Embiid with the block.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
It hasn't taken them any time to find their rhythm in the second half. 4 for 4 from the field already.
Lowry against Simmons. And it's Lowry penetrating, lays it up off the glass. Lowry's got 11 points.
A veteran guard with a knack for penetrating defenses. Lowry can pretty much get any shot he wants.
Now here is Harris. He's got 8. Pass to Embiid. Shot clock at 6. That one is good again. He's 6 for 8 from the floor with the basket.
Wow, 5 straight buckets coming out of half. They are rolling.
Simmons against Lowry. Siakam inside. Oh, and he plucks it off the glass. Wow. And now here comes Simmons leading the break. And Simmons slams it in.
That's just the sheer strength of Simmons. You want to try to tie him down? He's going to fight hard for every bucket.
The 76ers shooting their 7th free throw attempt here. And Toronto making a change here. Boucher is checked in. That's good from Simmons. We're negotiating concession the league wants from the players' union. Prospect attendance Chris, at the draft combine and team-wide access to player physicals.
Well, this is a tough one because I don't think that a team that is not interested in you should have your physical. And we all know that information is shared, and so it should be genuine in the teams that are truly interested. And so I understand agents holding back on that. Medical information is something very serious that just because you have an opportunity to be drafted, your information shouldn't be spread all across the world just because you're at a combine. It'll be interesting to see how it plays out, but basically you just want a level playing field for everyone. And if we have that, it'll be better for everyone.
Well, it's been an express lane to the rim. Coach can't be happy about that.
Poor rotations. I mean, slow help and just not enough toughness on the interior. They've got a lot to talk about.
Now a chance, guys, to examine the rebounding numbers over the past months for Horford.
And those are some numbers that he can't be happy about. His rebounding totals have taken a dip over the past few months. He's got to get back to giving the kind of effort on the boards we were seeing from him earlier.
Now here's Powell. And the call will be against Al Horford. That is his first foul of the game. Third quarter action and just under 3.5 minutes have gone. Pass to Powell. 6 on the shot clock. From deep.
Oh, it's such a disciplined defender. I mean, Horford with the mobility to get to the right spot and put his size to use.
Feibel, the pass to Horford. Burke kicks to Horford. Passes it to Feibel. Back to Horford. Shoots over Powell. Horford, no luck. Raptors trail by 18. To the middle, here's Ibaka. Ben Simmons with the rebound.
That's a shot they're always happy to give, even when he blows the finish.
To the inside, and O'Quinn slams it in.
Oh, that's some skill on that assist. I mean, the timing has to be perfect on a lead pass.
Toronto's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Here's Boucher, guarded by Horford, and Ibaka kicks to Lowry. Just 5 to shoot. Looking to end the run. Good for another field goal. Number 5 in the night. 5 for 10 shooting.
Deceptive and skilled at that guard position. When Lowry's scoring like this, good luck trying to defend him.
Now, here's Burke. He dishes it to Simmons. Out to the right wing. Unloads from 13. Got a piece of it. Poked loose. Ibaka dishes to Lowry. And the pass to Hollis Jefferson. Back to Lowry. Sinks the three-pointer. Lowry's got 7 points here in this quarter.
As hot as he's been, it still has to be him who leads the charge and helps turn this game around.
Burke, the pass to Horford. Back to Burke. It doesn't go for him. And Toronto will come the other way. Here's Lowry. Pass to Boucher. Here's Hollis Jefferson. No good with the triple. The 76ers leading by 15. Pass to Simmons. And Simmons slams it in.
Such an impressive athlete. The way Simmons moves on the drive is so natural and under control.
Powell with it. Outside Lowry. Fires it up. Lowry can't get that one to fall.
+8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
And here is Simmons. 14 points for him. Horford trying to free himself up. Shots good by Simmons. Simmons got 16.
Give him another. Simmons is terrific tonight. He's figuring out ways to light it up.
Raptors trail by 19. Now Powell. Lowry up top. Again, the miss by Lowry. Philadelphia's gone 3 of 4 from long range in the game. Now here's Burke. Lowry covering. And the 76ers tack on 2 more.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
Starting to take over here, building a big lead that could ultimately prove insurmountable.
Now here's Powell. Kicks it to Lowry. Over Burke. And Lowry gets it to go. Lowry's got 9 points here in the second half.
And that's Lowry's shot right there. Always looking to capitalize from that range.
Timeout called, the 76ers.
And team strategies closely guarded, one aspect of the game the fans aren't always privy to.
Yeah, and sometimes, Greg, it's the most subtle moves that make the biggest difference.
It seems like every shot these guys have been putting up has been going in. This month's top shooters, Ben Simmons is second.
It would be hard to imagine him shooting the ball much better than he has. He has been on fire.
He kicks to Horford. Simmons trying to get open. Good work defensively by Gasol. Raptors trail by 19. Here's Anunoby. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. Two seasons at Indiana for OG Anunoby and the 23rd pick of the 2017 draft. Great talk about his game.
You know, NBA ready physically from day one. You know, still working for consistency with his shooting, especially at the free throw line. But I like his potential as a two-way player.
Take a break. Two shots.
And he knocks down the first one.
And the potential Anunoby has is exciting. Has the athleticism, the shooting touch, and the drive to keep improving.
Catching up on the changes for Philadelphia. Embiid comes in for Al Horford. And Tobias Harris subbed in for Trey Burke. And the Raptors also making a change. Siakam is checked in for Serge Ibaka. That misses, so he splits the free throws.
Well, you look at the career of Tobias Harris, and, boy, he's bounced around a bit. Has never slowed his development or production, though. You put him anywhere, and he'll find a way to help his team.
And with Harris, he's been moved so many times. You know what, Greg? You forget he's still quite young.
Yeah, I mean, he really is just starting to enter what should be the prime of his career. Has improved every offseason and is a great rebounder and scorer.
That's good from Simmons.
I mean, you got to love the skill set Simmons possesses. A nightly triple-double threat. He stuffs the stat sheet.
Lowry with the ball. Now guarded by Simmons. Passes it to Van Vliet. And there's the pass to Gasol. Clock at two. And Philadelphia grabs the miss.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive.
Raptors trail by 21. And the shot will not go from Anunoby. Philadelphia has gone 3 of 4 from long range in the game. Oh, and there's the alley-oop. And stolen by Siakam. He blocks it again.
A defensive stalwart so far. That's 6 blocks.
Greg protecting the rim. Love the hustle. Josh Richardson's checked in for Philadelphia. Van Vliet finds Lowry. Now here's Van Vliet. He's tightly guarded. Pass to Anunoby. Clock at 6. Here's Siakam. No good from outside.
He's been cold, and it's been hurting him. The D, I mean, was ready for him. He hasn't been able to solve it.
With the fadeaway, and the shot goes in. Harris has got 10.
Oh, he keeps that mid-range jump shot alive. I love seeing Harris utilize this area of the floor.
Now here's Van Vliet. 12 points for him, and that one, good.
That's a perfect setup. Solid screen, defender can't avoid it. Opens up a clear path to the bucket.
Richardson against Lowry. Here's Embiid. That shot off. Now here's Lowry. And so it's Ben Simmons making highlights for the Philadelphia 76ers. He totaled 14 points in the quarter. He's given them all the offense they need right now. We come back right after this. How about a look at today's State Farm assist of the game?
And he sliced the D wide open with his feed. They had no chance to prevent that basket.
No, that's quick decision making. You see a guy open, you can't hesitate. That's an outstanding play.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same from the first three quarters. We've got Ennis. Tobias Harris is out there with Scott. Then it's Joel Embiid, and it's Richardson in at the one spot. That's the group on the floor for Philadelphia. And he's good on the three ball.
Good at recognizing when the defense is overcommitted. I mean, Embiid is terrific at sharing the ball.
Raptors shooting at 36% on the night. They've got to step it up offensively. Here's Van Vliet at the top of the key. Lowry got a piece of it.
Oh, he's not going to miss that shot twice in a row. Trust me.
Pass to Richardson. And Chris, underclassmen entering the draft, they can now hire agents, get help attending workouts, and still retain their eligibility. Do you like that move?
I love the move, Kevin. You know what it does? It helps Lester fall by the wayside. So you come out of college, you don't know how good you are. You don't, it's based off ego, how hard you worked, family and friends telling you, go, get the money. But what's your testing ground? You don't know. You don't have a full context. So I love the fact that it lets you go out there and see. And if you have any trepidation, go back to school. You got another year. So, yes, I love this move.
Excellent. See you, Webb. Excellent. The first one falls. Some changes for Philadelphia. Jonah Bolden comes in for Embiid, and Raul Neto is subbed in for Tobias Harris. A new group in now for the Raptors. Johnson, he's checked in for Siakam. Thomas comes in for OG Anunoby. Davis is checked in for Fred VanVleet. And it's Patrick McCaw in for Kyle Lowry. And Ennis drops them both.
And if they continue, Kevin, their outstanding free throw shooting, that'll help them seal the deal.
Just over a minute played here in the fourth. Here's Johnson. Count the bucket. And he's got a free throw coming up as well.
Well, what about the concentration of Johnson? Just burying the bucket despite the harm.
And the NBA is seeming to be at the crossroads of sports and fashion and Chris, music. Do you think it's always been this interwoven?
Oh, Kevin, please. You see the outfits they're wearing now? Now I got to be like the fuddy-duddy, the old guy. Oh, my goodness. Guys are basically coming into the game like, did you turn on the lights before you got dressed in your closet? Yeah. I mean, I know it's fashion. I'm not speaking about any one guy, but wow. I'm telling you, they've taken fashion to another level. And even though I joke about it, it's always fun anticipating what type of outfit I'm going to see guys walk in. Especially, I mean, come on. I love their games. And then I look and I say, wow. They have to be confident on the court because they wore that to the game. They're confident in life all around.
Overall, right.
Yes.
Well, maybe not the most well-known player in the league, but Josh Richardson has been a big source of offense, and Greg, he's done it for a while now.
A bit of a specialist, but Richardson has no problem putting up and making threes.
That's good from Richardson. Ananobi, he's checked in for Toronto. And so he hits both. Toronto shooting around 36%. They're just not able to finish consistently. Siakam kicks to Powell. And again, no good by Toronto. Philadelphia's gone a very strong 4-for-5 from three-point land in the ballgame. No good from Simmons. The Raptors have gone 1-of-3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. Ananobi passes to Van Vliet. Hey, Chris, for some guys, playing in their hometown is a dream. But there's also that added pressure, isn't there?
Oh, yeah, definitely. At least when you play away from home, it's a little more quiet. You don't have to get as many tickets for the game. And I got a chance to play home in Detroit. It was one of the best moments of my life. And I thought to myself, this is a wonderful feeling, but could I have handled it for 15 years of my career? I don't know. That's 30 tickets a game. Oh, I probably would have to go back into the NBA again just to pay for those tickets. But I tell you what, it's fun. And for me, a mama's boy, eating your mama's cooking before a game, it is never, ever. I've never had a better feeling before a game. Eating her food and being able to go out and play.
I bet.
But when you allow good scorers to get uncontested shots at the rim, no wonder you're losing.
Yeah. Horrible effort. It appears they may be on the brink of giving up.
Now here's Paul. Siakam outside. There's another block, making his presence felt on this end.
He's holding down the fort, anchoring the defense.
And the 76ers making a change here. Korkmaz is checked in, and Toronto also making a switch. Boucher is checked in. And just about 3 minutes through the fourth quarter here, the shot by Powell, no good.
And there have been some terrible shot choices here, Kev. That's not a good look at all.
No good from Simmons. And so Van Vliet will bring it up for Toronto. Ananobi in the corner. Boucher kicks to Powell. Raptors moving the ball around. Here's Ananobi. Guarded by Simmons. Shot clock at 5. Can they get it? And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. Chris, the other day, Adam Silver has been talking about how the All-Star game, that system, is not working. He's been proactive in considering alternatives. What do you think?
Well, I love what he's done already. Just think about the All-Star game in 2019. Letting guys pick their players. Like old school on the park, I mean, that adds a little bit of ego, and that's what you want because we want competition. We want guys that like each other, don't like each other, that are playing against each other, that we're in the finals against each other. We want all that competition, all that mental game that goes into it. And so I love the fact that he's outspoken, that he's definitely ahead of the problem. But I think he did a great job by letting players pick their teammates because that already causes a little in-team drama that we'll see play out on the floor with how hard guys are playing.
Here's what Toronto's going with right now. Hollis Jefferson's checked in for Ananobi. Davis is subbed in for Powell. A look at the clock, a little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth. Inside, Richardson. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
At the line for 2.
Two shots. Relax on the first.
And he makes the first. And along with the association, we've seen the growth of the G League, the WNBA, the 2K League. Chris, which of those have you followed the most?
Well, first let me say I should have been drafted by the 2K League because I'm really nice. Matter of fact, anybody listening to the sound of my voice, I will beat you in the game that I'm talking on right now. But secondly,
I know you will.
I love the WNBA from Lisa Leslie to Cheryl Swoops to my girl Candace Parker. Are you kidding me? The skill set of these ladies? Oh, they have game. And I can't say I follow one the most because even the G League and their All-Star game I follow. Right now it's a great time for hoops, and all three of these leagues I'm in on. Shooting.
At the line for two.
Oh, take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
He misses the free throw. And the second free throw, good. So it's Philadelphia now. So far in the fourth quarter, they've allowed just 6 points. Korkmaz passes to Thibel. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. And now a chance to see what's coming up for the Philadelphia 76ers. On Thursday, they'll tip off a road trip in Charlotte where they'll take on the Hornets. And then on Saturday, the Atlanta Hawks come into town. That will tip off a homestand for them.
And for that game against the Bulls, this is one where it would take a complete meltdown for them not to come away with the win. Anything can happen, but I'd be shocked if they don't come out on top.
And the first one at the line is good. Chris, I read this the other day, the NBA announcing the development of the BAL, the Basketball African League. They feel there's a lot of untapped potential there. I would tend to agree.
I'm so excited. I already put my name in the hat to go out there and work with and help develop
these
kids. Oh,
good,
yeah, I'm excited. I mean, just think about this. You want to know what type of talent is out there? Let's just start with Akeem. Then we go to Mutombo, Embiid. He's from Cameroon. How about Antetokounmpo, who has Nigerian parents? We can keep on going. How about Ibaka help find Siakam? Oh, my goodness.
Yep.
There's some talent out there, baby. And, yes, I'm excited for the BAL, the Basketball African League. Africa, stand up, baby.
Now here is Davis. And, again, Toronto, no luck. Here's Korkmaz. Tries again. The rebound by Ibaka. And so it's Davis. He'll bring the ball up for Toronto. Four on the clock. From deep three-point range, the long-distance three is buried. Davis has got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. Richardson outside. Let's a floater go. That's no good. It's his second miss. He's made four. Outside, Davis. Passes it to Hollis Jefferson. Back to Davis. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. O'Quinn's got seven rebounds in the game. Here's Thibel. Now the pass to Korkmaz. Floor spacing, Chris, now so big in the NBA. And big men have the room to put up some unbelievable numbers.
Oh, man, look at Lopez out there in Bucks land. I mean, look what he's doing in Milwaukee, just shooting threes from deep. The same, you got to go to Embiid, Porzingis, and we've already seen what the great Dirk Nowitzki has done through his career spacing the floor. Look, it adds time on to your career because you don't have to just go down there and bang and be one-dimensional in the paint. Your teammates better because now you're spacing the floor, which gives them room to drive. And if you're really working on your game, you can really make your teammates better because now you have more passing lanes because you're further away from the basket. So as any post player knows, it's a blessing to be surrounded by great shooters. And now big men, they got a little more room out there.
That free throw good from Hollis Jefferson. Some changes for Philadelphia. Jonah Bolden's checked in for Scott. And Raul Neto's subbed in for Josh Richardson. Johnson, he's checked in for Toronto. And he makes both free throws. The 76ers leading by 23. Pass to Bolden. Some nice ball movement here by the 76ers. Tries to keep it alive. And so it looks like the 76ers will retain possession here. And the Raptors going out now with a whole new group. Simmons against Lowry. Shot clock at 6. From deep. The 76ers again can't hit it. Toronto's gone into a funk from downtown in the fourth. Only one of their 5 three-pointers has found the bottom of the bucket.
And all of a sudden, things finally coming together for them. The deficit's still large, but now not insurmountable.
And the longer the run goes on, the more momentum will swing their way.
Embiid trying to break loose. Richardson for 3. It's rebounded by Anunoby.
And not his best day from 3-point range. I mean, just 1 in the first half and still looking for his first here in half number 2.
Siakam kicks to Lowry. Gasol against Embiid. Now here is Lowry. Defense is right there.
Strong D on the perimeter. That's how you got to play.
Richardson outside. See, Webb, if we lower the draft age back to 18, the league will take a larger role developing high school players. Your thoughts?
Well, I think it could be a safety net. You know, so many kids are vulnerable at this time, and they don't have a system. And that's why everything's kind of been messed up for players, trying to figure out what is the correct system. How do I really get immersed? I want to be in the NBA. What is the right way? And I think the younger you are, with the more direction that you have, it can only turn out to be a safer process, I would hope.
And getting better pro-level training, too, coaching.
Yeah, pro-level training, pro-level knowledge, pro-level relationships. I think it's a great thing by the league.
Here's Simmons, following the basket by Mark Gasol. Horford kicks to Simmons. To the paint. He's looking for Richardson and finds him. Rejected by Gasol.
You got to be wary of Gasol. I mean, he's good at using his length to turn away shots.
Simmons with it. Richardson outside. Pass to Embiid. Trying to end the drought. Gasol with the rebound. Gasol's got his 5th rebound right now in the game.
And this is going to end in a lopsided victory. I love the tenacity and aggressiveness as well as the ability to close. You really got to give it up here for the 76ers.
Their inside game was what secured them the win tonight.
They had their way in the paint. And those are all high percentage shots, but the defense couldn't stop them from getting down low.
And on the year, looking at their record, this game will make it 49 wins.
And they cap off the season series with 1 more win. It's been nothing but W's 4 straight.
And as one might have guessed coming into this game, it was indeed another big game tonight for Ben Simmons.
What a teammate he was tonight, setting guys up for layups and open jumpers on what seemed like every possession.
They're making this a runaway.
And the only question for me right now is just how big the lead will eventually become.
And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Very difficult to deal with inside. I mean, once Embiid gets the positioning he wants, you almost have to follow.
Joel Embiid taking two shots.
Two shots. Relax on the first.
The free throw drops for Embiid.
And the Hakeem Olajuwon comparisons, they're somewhat legitimate. I mean, Embiid's skill set and size is something you don't see very often.
That one falls, so he hits both of them. 4 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Davis looking for an opening. Simmons against Thomas. Passes to Boucher.
Good D.
Davis up top. Launches a three. He can't get that one. So it's the 76ers winning this one easily. They won this game going away. They were the better basketball team by far tonight.
And you got to commend this sort of dominance, particularly here at home. It's a great feeling when you play almost a perfect game and to have that crowd be so pumped up.
And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Chris Weber, Greg Anthony, and David Holmes, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. See you next time.